and I cannot lie.
What happens if you take the flavors of duck ramen and turn it into a sandwich? That wasn't what we set out to do, but that's where we ended up. And I regret nothing. I decided to make this roast pork butt sandwich from Lady and Pups because I ended up with some broccoli rabe and I needed a way to use it all up.
It sounded like a tasty sandwich,
and then we made it, and oh my gosh, it's such a good sandwich. So let's make the sandwich happen. Start by toasting some fennel and coriander seeds in a pan until they are nice and toasty and fragrant, and then grind them up. I used a mortar and pestle, but a spice or coffee grinder would work great for this as well. At this point, they are so wonderfully fragrant, a little anisey, so redolent of five spice or the flavors of pho. Peel and smash, or smash and peel, some garlic, and then slice up some ginger. Now we're going to cut about 2 pounds of pork butt, also known as pork shoulder, into large chunks, and then put them in a deep baking dish. They will release a lot of juices and fat as they cook, so you want something with high edges. Rub your pork with those ground spices that we just toasted up, some fish sauce for umami, salt, black pepper, and white pepper. Top all of that with that crushed garlic and then sliced ginger. Now it's time for roasting. We are going low and slow at only about 300 degrees Fahrenheit for about 2.5 hours. By now, your kitchen probably smells amazing. So you can take the pork out of the oven and let it cool. At this point, if you want to do this ahead of time, you can refrigerate the pork with all of its fat and juices overnight like we did in an airtight container. Or you can just move on directly to the next step. When you are ready to make your sandwiches, now we finish everything else. Before we pan fry the pork, because we're gonna get that nice and crispy, I like to do the broccoli rabe first so we can just use the same pan without having to wash it out or anything in between. Wash and dry your broccoli rabe and then cut it in half. And when I say dry, I mean dry it really, really, really well, because we're going to be pan frying this, and adding water to the hot oil means popping everywhere. We're gonna try to avoid that. Add a bit of olive oil to a large nonstick pan and heat that over high heat. Add in your broccoli rabe, and I would suggest having a splatter screen or a lid ready, because if it's not 100% dry, and it is hard to get broccoli rabe completely dry, then there will be splattering. At this point, you can let it sit and cook for a bit because you want it to brown and get nice and caramelized, and then flip it so that happens on the other side as well. Since you want your broccoli rabe to be in a single layer on the pan so it can all get browned, you will probably have to do this in batches. So set aside each batch on a plate when it's done and finish cooking all the rest of your broccoli rabe. After you've cooked all the broccoli rabe, add it all back to the pan all at once. At this point, you can add a few cloves worth of minced garlic, some salt, and some freshly ground black pepper, and toss that all together. Cook it, tossing, just until the garlic starts to get fragrant, but no further than that because we don't want the garlic to burn and get bitter. Once you can start to smell the garlic cooking, remove it from the heat and set it aside on a plate. Now it's time to get back to the pork. Set aside the ginger slices that we cooked it with, but make sure to keep the garlic because we're gonna be using that. If, like us, you refrigerated the pork, there should be a good layer of fat on top. You can actually take that off and set it aside and save it for any time you wanna add some porky goodness. You can use it in place of oil or butter for your cooking. Using a couple of forks, tear your pork into chunks. You don't need to completely shred it, but about 1-inch chunks will be good for this. Then put the pork and the cooked garlic into that pan that you cooked the broccoli rabe in. If you refrigerated the pork, then you'll probably have a good bit of gelled broth sticking to it. This is good this is what we want. However, if you are cooking this immediately after cooking the pork and everything's still warm, then go ahead and add about a quarter cup of the drippings to the pan with the pork. Cook all of this, flipping once or twice until everything's starting to get nice and brown and crisping up wonderfully. It is really gonna start smelling like a good banh or duck ramen. Once your meat is browned, add in the rest of your drippings or the rest of that gelled broth. Let that cook until everything is warmed through and just combined. And now it is time to make some sandwiches. Cut some rolls in half and lightly toast them. The original recipe called for Dijon mustard, but even though we're usually mustard lovers, we found it to be a bit too sharp and contrasted with the rest of the ingredients in a way that we didn't really love. So we are going with kewpie mayo instead. Ladle the pork along with just a little bit of the juices. You want it to be moist but not soggy onto your buns. Then top it with some of that caramelized broccoli rabe. And if you're feeling really decadent, you can top it with a fried egg as well. This will really go for that ramen vibe. And we tested it out and can confirm it is delicious. Pickled peppers are optional, but we highly recommend them because we found that it does cut through the richness of everything else in the sandwich. Any other sort of pickles would be tasty here as well. I would totally go for the Vietnamese pickles that you get in banh mi. If you are a cilantro fan, that would also be a good decision, but I might just be biased because I pretty much want every sandwich to be a banh mi. The original recipe also suggested sliced provolone as an optional addition to the sandwich, but we did not try that because I may or may not have used all of the provolone for those tasty Philly cheese steak sloppy joes. So we didn't have any left, so we didn't try that. And there you have the roast pork butt sandwich that pretty much tastes like ramen in a sandwich. It's so good. We are going to taste it very, very soon, but if you are new to the channel and you're not subscribed yet, make sure to hit that sub button because we have lots of tasty stuff coming up very soon. Let's go eat. I am extremely ready to be ramen. This roast pork butt sandwich that tastes like duck ramen.
It's the bomb, baby.
It's bombing.
It's tasting time. The bread is a little bit stale, huh? I think it's a little bit old. It's crunchy though.
See, I did this on purpose.
Mm-hmm,
just for the ASMR.
Professional.
Okay, so we keep mentioning duck ramen, even though it's pork, but something about the flavors that were used in cooking the pork, mm-hmm. and then the way it turns out so succulent, it's stringy, kind of like how duck is. We crisp it up at the end, and it just really, really ends up having the flavors and consistency of the kind of duck that you get in duck ramen.
Mm-hmm. It's so good.
It's so good.
It's so good.
This whole duck ramen idea, we didn't have it before making the sandwich. This was really just, oh, hey, that sandwich looks good. Let's try it. After having eaten this, we have actually taken the meat and the broccoli rabe and put it in instant ramen.
Oh,
and
so
can
good.
Confirm it is excellent.
The broccoli rabe,
mm-hmm.
is really good. It's a little bit bitter.
It is. It's more bitter than normal broccoli is.
It's a little bit bitter, mm-hmm. and it reminds me of like a bitter bok choy.
Because it's much more leafy,
mm-hmm.
than broccoli is, and it's got those stems. It worked out really well for this because the bitterness does help kind of cut.
Yeah, balance the richness, yeah, decadent of the
pork is very rich, very fatty, really good, but it needs something to cut it. And I think also that's why, for me, the peppers are so necessary for this, mm-hmm. is because it really cuts the fat. It cuts the richness, so it makes it just, you want to eat more instead, yes. of like, okay, I've maybe had enough.
Yeah.
I did think though that the mustard
I was surprised that I didn't like that because I really thought I was going to be into it, but it didn't go as well as I thought it would for this.
I think the reason is because the mustard is very strongly flavored.
It's very sharp.
Mm-hmm. And everything else is already decadent and rich. So you get this richness and too many things
battling sharp flavor, strong flavors,
mm-hmm.
battling for your attention.
Yeah.
And so it kind of takes away from the pork instead of complementing the pork.
Yeah.
But overall, I am very happy
with
the components of the sandwich. Again, we will not be using the leftovers in sandwiches, although it is, I do like the sandwich, mm-hmm. but I like it even better in ramen.
I think that we should cook every protein we cook from now on should just be cooked this way. This style, this flavor, it's just wonderful. It works.
He was
the five spice.
Can we do chicken like this?
We do chicken. We can do duck. Well, obviously duck. Maybe fish. Maybe tofu. Not maybe. Definitely tofu.
You could do tofu.
Yeah, that would be good. That would be delicious.
I wouldn't cook it in the same style though. No, because I'm just like tofu for 2.5 hours in the oven. That's how you get dried tofu.
Stay tuned. Next week, we're going to do that.
Thank you so much for watching. We've got lots more good food coming up. So if you could leave a little like on this video, that would help our little channel. And if you want to share this with anybody you think would be into this sandwich or just into the stuff that we make on our channel in general, that would be a huge help as well. We'll see you next time.